I'm about to get on a light rail train, and like most places in the world, you have to pay to use transit, either ahead of time or on board. But what if I didn't have to pay? What if nobody did? I'd argue that we'd all be better off, even if you never rode a bus or a train. The idea of offering free public transit isn't as crazy as you might think. Plenty of cities offer free transit to students and seniors. Others offer free transit designated zones or routes. Some cities, like Seoul, offer free transit on smoggy days. But very few cities have done what I'm proposing, offering completely free transit to everyone, everywhere. Estonia's capital is the largest and most notable example. Its residents get free mass transit. The city has inspired others to consider it as well, perhaps most notably Paris. So it's not a totally crazy idea, but why would a city give up all of that fare revenue? What are the benefits? Well, for one thing, ridership. One Belgian city eliminated fares that saw ridership increase 13-fold. Research on free transit schemes in the U.S. found about a 50% increase in ridership is typical. That's still huge. More transit ridership could mean a decrease in the number of cars on the road, assuming that people switch to transit from cars. This would lead to lower greenhouse gas emissions and help curb climate change. It would also improve air quality. Transit would also be easier to use. No need to download an app or have correct change or worry about a transfer. The barrier to use is eliminated. It's so easy. Now, I know what some of you are thinking. There's no way you get me out of my car and onto that bus. You couldn't even pay me to do it. But transit still benefits you. You should hope that everybody you're stuck in traffic with decides to take the bus instead of being in the car on the highway with you. Service could also be improved with free transit. Buses and trains that collect fares on board wouldn't have to do that anymore, speeding up service. This could allow for more trains and buses or shorter headways. That improves transit for everyone. The biggest reason to make transit free is a philosophical one. We have decided that essential services like police, fire, roads, highways, and bridges are all free in the sense that we pay for them in taxes and we use them for free as much as we like, or need to in the case of police and fire. They're considered essential public services. Now, I've heard the argument that transit should operate like a business and make a profit, but we don't ask the streets in front of our house to make a profit. We pay for those through taxes. Access is another key consideration. In order to use roads, you need to have access to a car. That's a huge barrier for a lot of people. If we think mobility is something worth paying for in taxes, we should include transit along with roads to ensure everyone can move through our cities, regardless of car ownership or not. You might say, well, aren't self-driving cars coming? And isn't Uber a thing? They are, but they bring their own problems. That's a topic for another video. This conversation around taxes brings up another point, the asterisk in the video's title. Now, I'm not advocating for making transit truly free. I'm talking about moving the cost from individual users onto taxpayers as a whole. Now, again, you might be thinking, that's not fair. I'll never use transit. Why should I pay for it? But again, there's a societal benefit here. It's like paying for schools in your district you may not attend, or paying for parks you never visit. When you pay for them, you receive indirect benefits, like an educated populace and fresh air. You're already paying for transit and taxes, you'd just be paying more and getting a lot more benefits, like the ones I described earlier in this video. Now, this proposal isn't perfect. There are other considerations besides taxes. A 2003 study by the federal government found that transit managers did not recommend completely free transit in large U.S. cities. They found that ridership increased amongst homeless people and drove away some of the choice riders, those who have a choice between transit and cars. When the agencies tried to combat this problem with more security, operational costs went up. That's not an insignificant problem, but I think it speaks more to the lack of a strong social safety net here in the United States than it is a real critique of free public transit. Oh, I think this is my stop. Now, I know that most cities aren't ready to implement free mass transit yet. Here in the United States, transit agencies are struggling to maintain service with stagnant and shrinking budgets. But I hope this video made you think about the benefits we would all see if we made transit more accessible to everyone. So I'm waiting for another train, and while I'm doing it, I'm listening to The Death and Life of Great American Cities by Jane Jacobs. It's one of my favorite books on the topic of planning. Listening to books is a great way to kill time while you're waiting for the train or on the train. I'd also recommend checking out Audible. To get started, you can support City Beautiful and go to audible.com/citybeautiful or text code citybeautiful to 500500. They have all kinds of great books about cities for your listening convenience. The great thing about Audible is that you can listen to all of these great books on your phone, on your tablet, while you're on transit, and yes, even when you're in your car. Audible members get a credit every month good for any audiobook in the store, regardless of price, and unused credits roll over to the next month. Didn't like your audiobook? You can exchange it, no questions asked. Start a 30-day trial and your first audiobook is free, so there's really no reason not to give it a try. Go to audible.com/CITYBEAUTIFUL or text CITYBEAUTIFUL to 500500. If you're interested in the future of urban transportation, check out the latest video over on Polymatter. It goes into self-driving cars, Uber, and other cool transportation innovations. Polymatter is a great channel, and I can't recommend it highly enough.